Zhou Yu, you've always helped Sun Quan, and now our kingdom is huge. That's why we're going to fight that man Cao Cao. According to Zhou Yu, this Cao Cao is a really mean guy that can't be left ignored. He was really mad. I wonder what happened. I'm not really sure, but anyone who makes my Zhou Yu mad makes me mad too. Let's go, Zhou Yu! Let's do this together!
Damn you, Cao Cao! If you had just spoken of your ambitions for the land, I would have ignored you. But you desire more than just the land. My beloved Xiao Qiao. Forgive me, I got a little carried away. This has nothing to do with you. Do not worry about it. The next battle shall take place at Chi B. We must support the missions of our fellow officers in order for this strategy to succeed. Let's go, Xiao Qiao. But remember, do not leave my side.
This battle has us treading in very dangerous waters. If we are to defeat Cao Cao's army, it is absolutely essential that you complete your missions. Men, this river shall guide us to our future!
This time, we'll face our enemy with fire. Follow Zhou Yu's instructions to bring home a victory.
Stand your ground until their offensive subsides.
I'm invincible! I'm with you, Zhou Yu!
This won't be easy.
Why not knock down the walls? The battle's ours if we seal off the central route.
Come on.
show them the strength of our forces.
To die in such a horrible place.
Come back later and try again.
The bridge is still standing? What's taking so long?
Over already.
Come back later and try again.
We're taking down the bridge. Withdraw at once.
One guy, occupy the central enemy ship.
About this.
This won't be easy.
Unfulfilled.
Come back later and try again.
We have nothing to fear from the enemy.
Now is our chance to overwhelm the enemy.
Excellent timing! Let's finish this!
Ah!
will now commence my prayer for wind. Cannot afford this interruption.
Yes, my time has come.
Just what? Send out a ship and resecure it.
That went quite well, if I do say so myself. But this battle is far from over. Now, the difficult part begins. How about that? Plan works, Master Shouyu.
The fire will be twice as deadly if they can't move. Blocking their route was brilliant.
Surpassed my might. Impressive.
Come back later and try again.
Embark and head straight for the enemy ships. Heavens bear witness! This fire burns with the spirit of Wu!
It worked. Begin the counterattack. Your treachery shall not go unpunished.
We should be able to handle this.
It's over already.
Come back later and try again.
shall show no mercy.
The wind. Now the time has come. We shall lay our hopes on this wind and have it carry them to the enemy.
Wind! No! Our fleet is burning!
You're by yourself. You must have some courage. So, my might was not enough.
Come back later and try again.
Let's not overestimate your abilities now.
I'm not dying here on this river. You are!
Stay focused on the matter at hand.
Nice try, but you'll never stand a chance against me. You dare try that right in front of me? My head without a fight.
Ambitions left unfulfilled.
Come back later and try again.
The world's greatest general.
This battle's starting to heat up. It's about time.
Someday, you shall pay for this.
Come back later and try again!
The villain Xiao Qiao and his giant fleet have sunk into the watery depths of Xiangdong. His determination to conquer the land never to resurface again. Victory is ours. The day of a land under Wu is close at hand. These waters shall serve as a battlefield. And word of our exploits here shall go down in legend.
It was during the final days of the year 200 AD when the Han Dynasty saw its end. Its demise ushered in a new era of chaos, brought on by several regional lords vying to rule China. There were those who sought absolute power, as well as those who fought for justice, and some simply fought for the sake of their beliefs. Many would rise and fall in their attempts to dominate the land. Xiao Qiao, second daughter of the altruistic Qiao Xuan. Xiao Qiao was especially known for her wit and great beauty. Together with her older sister Da Qiao, they would be known as the two Qiaos. The Qiao sisters were placed under the protection of Sun Ce during his conquest of Xiangdong. After the battle, Sun Ce married Da Qiao, while Zhou Yu married Xiao Qiao. The two couples got along very well, and the two sisters supported their husbands by helping them on the battlefield. Wu, which had become strong after battling the Yellow Turbans and participating in the campaign against Dong Zhuo, continued to show its might by defeating Liu Biao at Jing. However, Sun Jian was killed during the battle, and Sun Ce became the new ruler. Accompanied by Zhou Yu, Sun Ce continued his conquest of the land. Xiao Qiao helped her husband by accompanying him on the battlefield, thus contributing to the expansion of their kingdom. Sun Ce died from illness, and Zhou Yu was entrusted with Wu. Xiao Qiao was there to cheer up her bereaving husband and continue to support him in his new duties, both on and off the battlefield. Despite Wu's successful unification of the land, Zhou Yu would be unable to rest. He was now occupied with governing the new land. However, Xiao Qiao was always there to support him. These tales, passed on for generations, have endured the tests of time and live on even today.
Indeed. I guess now I have to devote myself entirely to you instead.